I'm Jim Turner, and welcome to DLife TV Online. It's going to be a great show in a new place. We'll be here Sundays at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, with new shows about living your DLife. Every week, we'll be sharing insights, recipes from the DLife kitchen, stories about real people living and achieving with diabetes, and so much more. We're glad you're here. Now on with the show.
I'm Joy Pape, Certified Diabetes Educator with DLifeTV.com, and I'm here to answer the DLife TV mail. A viewer asked, I forget to take my insulin at night. What can I do? Well, this is a question I hear a lot. So, first of all, we need to figure out how to make it work for you. Let's come up with a plan. Does it work for you to take your insulin at night? It doesn't have to be taken at night necessarily, but it needs to be taken once a day and not at different times of the day. If you're going to be taking it at night, think about pairing it up with something else you regularly do to help you remember to take it. For example, if you take it at bedtime, how about putting your insulin on your pillow so that when you go to bed, you always see it? Or if you happen to brush your teeth every night, put it by the toothbrush, but something that you do every night. And if that doesn't work for you, talk to your healthcare provider about changing it to another time of day. Some people find they do better pairing it with the morning because a lot of people take their blood sugar first thing in the morning, and that's a time they may remember to take it. You can put your insulin near your meter or your insulin near your coffee maker or your coffee cup. It's something that you do every day. Again, work with your healthcare team on how to make that switch. Another way to remember is to think of some reminders. One reminder could be ask someone you know and love to remind you about your insulin. Or you can use technology, such as setting the alarm on your smartphone, even setting your alarm clock to remind you. Sometimes people aren't sure if they've taken their insulin or not. What do you do in that case? Well, you will need to call your healthcare provider to find out if you should take it or not. But first, check your blood sugar so you have enough information when you call. Another way to prevent not knowing if you took your insulin is to have something near your insulin that you can check off or make a note every time you take your insulin. Joy Pape, Certified Diabetes Educator, DLifeTV.com.
Hi, I'm Chef Michel Nishan, and welcome to the DLife Kitchen. Now, how many of you have ever had borscht? Or maybe I should ask, do you even know what borscht is? Now, some people thumb their noses up at beets, and that's the base for borscht. But beets are really a diabetes superfood, really good for you, good for your blood sugar, also just super delicious and easy to work with. Now, here I have some already cooked beets. You can see that they're nice and soft, right? This is delicious. Now, that kind of hint or whisper of je ne sais quoi flavor, which is French for I don't know what it is, but I like it, is cucumber. Cucumber is in borscht. And what I'm gonna do is just peel. I'm not gonna take all the green off the cucumber, cut it in half lengthwise, and I'm just gonna scoop the seeds out of it. And then we're just gonna do a quick slice on these. So I got the cucumbers in there. I have some beets. Now these are cooked, you can roast them wrapped in foil for about an hour to an hour and a half, depending on the size of the beet, or you can simmer them, however you like to cook the beets. I like roasting them because it really keeps the flavor in there. One of the things that's wonderful about the beets, you see how red they are. The darker the color, the deeper the color, the more of the good things in there that make beets so good for you. Now, a lot of folks have said, but beets are sweet. Don't they have a lot of sugar? Ironically, yeah, beets are actually used to make sugar. You've heard of beet sugar. But the interesting thing about this particular recipe, only 10 grams of carbs. It's all that fiber and all of that other good stuff that goes along with the beets that makes them so good for you. So I have a little bit of homemade vegetable stock. I'm going to put in a half cup of sour cream, some red wine vinegar. And the great thing about the vinegar is it really helps kind of blunt that spike in your blood sugar. And then I have some really nice dill. A lot of people call it dill weed. I just call it dill. Now here, check this out. Pop it in the food processor. Just a couple of pulses like that. And then I'm gonna turn it on. And I'm gonna let it go for about 45 seconds to a minute. You really want this to smooth out. That's it, that's all. Believe it or not, that small amount of cucumber makes a huge difference. Look at that. That is just beautiful. We're gonna just ladle out a little bit of borscht. And I love to gussy it up just a little bit with some sour cream and some good old American paddlefish caviar. Now, the great thing about American paddlefish caviar is it's sustainable. It's just absolutely delicious. And you don't have to use a lot, so it really doesn't break the bank. And look at that. Easy Russian borscht. You can do this. You can also find this on dlife.com/recipebox. And after you make your own borscht, maybe even some of your own revisions, come back to the website, give us a review. I'm Michel Nashan. Thanks for joining me in the D-Life Kitchen.
Hi, I'm Lynn Prowitt for D-Life TV, and we are back in Palmer's Market in Darien, Connecticut. Today we are going to talk about whole grains. And I'm not talking about brown rice and whole wheat pasta. Blech. I am talking about expanding your horizons and getting a little creative. With all the amazing whole grain alternatives these days, it's really time to think about putting aside your rice, your potatoes, your pasta, and going for something a little different. If you haven't ever tried barley, barley is the number one lowest glycemic grain. Let me pull out some barley here. Pearled barley, hullless barley. Pearled barley cooks a little faster. Hullless barley is the less refined version. Both really good for you, really low glycemic impact. But remember, keep your portions small. Another great whole grain option that I love to recommend is quinoa. It's fun to say, quinoa. Quinoa is actually not even a whole grain, it's a seed. And it is unique because it's a complete protein. The only other vegetarian source of a complete protein are soybeans. So quinoa is a really special food. It can stand in for your meat, your seafood. Remember though, with whole grains, keep portions small. Quarter cup portion cooked, I recommend. The other thing you should know about grains is they're so easy to cook. You really just need any liquid. You can use water, chicken broth, vegetable broth, and generally you cook them with a 2-to-1 ratio liquid to grain. You can do almost anything with whole grains. They are so versatile and they absorb the flavor of whatever you're making. They're dense with nutrients, a much better alternative than your refined grains, your potatoes, the things we usually turn to. So here are some preparation ideas for getting whole grains into your repertoire. With barley, you can stir it into any soup. It's especially good with chicken soup or vegetables. And remember, barley is the lowest glycemic grain. You can also saute almost any grain with onions and mushrooms for a nice side dish. Olive oil or butter and grated Parmesan, and boom, you have another great side dish idea. Sauteed garlic and soy sauce, or try whisking in an egg for a fried rice kind of dish. You can also turn whole grains into a dessert by adding butter, cream, and berries or some other chopped fruit. Stir a whole grain into custard for a rice pudding kind of dessert. Here are a couple whole grain tips. First, pre-soak your grains. A couple hours of soaking will make them cook much faster. Toast grains in a small amount of butter or oil before cooking them. This will enhance the flavor and it'll also reduce the cooking time a bit. One more tip, don't stress when cooking your grains. If your grains are tender enough before the time is up, just strain out the liquid. If your grains are not tender enough, when the time is done, just add more liquid to it. So experiment with different types of grains. Let your family taste test. And remember, you should always blood sugar test right after. So for more information about grains, go to dlife.com/grains. I'm Lynn Prowitt for DLife TV. Thanks for watching.
I want to introduce you to Urban Miares. Urban is 65 years old, he's a champion skier, and he loves to sail by himself. Pretty amazing, huh? Oh, I forgot to tell you, Urban has been totally blind since 1984. He is the president of the Disabled Business Persons Association and a co-founder of Challenged America, a program that promotes sailing among people with disabilities. He's a motivational speaker and a consultant whose work has been recognized by President George H.W. Bush and Bill Clinton. So what was Urban doing at a TCOYD conference? Well, in 1968, while serving in the Army, he often complained about not feeling right.
They diagnosed everything from battle fatigue to peptic ulcers. And the company commander and first sergeant started threatening me. There was no real reason, according to the doctors, why I wasn't going out to combat.
He was finally diagnosed with type 1 diabetes, but the story of his diagnosis just might be the king of all diagnosis stories.
In 1968, in Vietnam, infantry platoon sergeant, 9th Infantry, and I was going out with my platoon. The enemy hit us, mortars and machine guns going off. I went unconscious, falling face first into the rice paddy. They put me in a body bag where I stayed for 2 days at base camp.
Urban's entire platoon was wiped out. On that second day, a medic, while checking toe tags, unzipped Urban's body bag and discovered that there was something different about this corpse. It was still breathing. He was put on a helicopter and rushed to a hospital in Saigon. Finally, he was correctly diagnosed with type 1 diabetes.
I got a silver bullet, no scratches, no nothing. I just went into a diabetic coma. And so if it wasn't for diabetes, I seriously wonder if I'd be here today.
When he got home, Urban was told he had 20 years to live. That was 44 years ago. Urban beat the odds and he's still around. Although at age 65, having had a stroke, his thyroid removed, a kidney transplant, nerve damage in his legs, type 1 diabetes, and total blindness, Urban likes to take it easy now.
You know, I do on average, you know, 60 to 80 speeches a year. This year it's been over 100. This has been one of my busiest years. If my health holds up, don't be surprised if you hear of me sailing around the world by myself nonstop.
So next time my diabetes gets me down, I'm gonna remember what Urban Miares told me.
We make our own life, we really do. The path we lead is our own choosing. It's fun, it's fun and it's great being a diabetic.
Yes, it is. That's the show for today. Thanks for tuning in. I know I learned a lot and I wanna know what you think. So be sure to share your thoughts in the comments below, and I'll see you here next Sunday, 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, for another exciting episode of DLife TV Online.